Training of spiritual warfare, and the goal here is to get you to see if you're ready for the war.
Man,
that's
man.
The goal, to get you to see if you're ready for the war. Right. Are you ready for war, or are you going to continue to live defeated lives?
Man, praise the Lord.
Oh man, y'all not hearing me. Are you ready for war, or are you going to continue to live defeated lives? Right now, I'm a recruiter today. My name is Sergeant Pastor Rico Holland. I'm a recruiter for God's Armed Forces, and I'm glad to have you here today. And my job is to invite you and give you information on God's Armed Forces. It may not be for you. You may not be equipped. You may not be ready for war. You may not be ready for the next level of warfare. But I do invite you in to get information, because I'll be honest with you, not everybody's going to pass the test.
Amen.
We'll still love you, and we'll still treat you with the love of God. But this particular series of teaching are for people who are ready to go to another level in their walk with the Lord, and who are tired of being whipped.
Amen.
Tired of being defeated all the time. Tired of falling victim to the same trial and tribulation.
Amen.
That's what this teaching is all about. Everybody's not going to pass, I'm going to tell you right now, because not everybody is willing to do what it takes to be a soldier.
Amen.
So they live comfortable in being in defeat. But once you begin to understand what God's purpose is for your life and what God has planned you to do, you can't stay defeated.
Man.
Oh my God, that's why some people ain't here today, because the enemy has tricked them to miss out on teaching.
Yes, Lord.
That's why another thing, I'm going to be honest with you, we got to be careful about our confession.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. We got to be careful, because when we confess things like, and I'm not knocking you, I'm not knocking your prayer, but when you confess things like, we may be small in number, but we're mighty in spirit. You ever notice those churches who say that all the time, never grow? Why? Because what you're saying is that I'm comfortable with where I am. Mm-hmm. I'm cool with it. When you say it, you're confessing something. And when you confess something, don't you know words carry spirits?
Mm-hmm. Man.
And when you confess something, the enemy says, oh, hey, cool, we're going to keep them right there. But when you start speaking above where you are,
amen,
elevation and promotion comes. That's the purpose of what I'm about to teach you in spiritual warfare, is you got to gear up in every aspect of your life if you're going to have some victory.
Thank you, Lord.
Man, I want victory.
Amen.
I want victory, man. I want to grow. I want to grow. I want to explode.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, I want to explode. I want to be in overflow. I want to be moving. I want to be climbing. I want to be escalating to purpose and destiny.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God. I'm in this today. I'm in this today. So now, I'm not going to hold you long, but I'm going to give what I got and be real about it. We're here for basic training. This is foundational information that any soldier in God's army must know. You got to know this.
Amen.
And so we're going to spend some time here with spiritual warfare, because this isn't something that I could just give you and glaze over for a few services and then you get it. One thing you're going to have to do is, I encourage you, is once we conclude this teaching, we're not selling a CD until it's all done. And I encourage all of you to go and get it. Please get it, because there's going to be a lot of information that's going to come forth that you can't just get hearing it.
Amen.
From me. I asked myself a question. And I said, why is it that you spend so much time and effort, putting so much of your time and effort on your days off into what you do? Just about 35, 45 minutes of teaching and word. Why don't you just do like other preachers do and just keep all of your sermons on file and go and preach them every year? I heard a preacher one time. He preached something 5 years. He preached something one day, and it was good to me, so I bought the tape. Mm-hmm. I came back 5 years later, he preached the same sermon. And I knew it word for word because I had listened to the tape 10 times at least. Mm-hmm. I could have got up there and preached more.
Because
I heard what he said. I got the tape. Why is it that I put so much time and effort into what I do when we don't spend that much time here? And I begin to realize, it's not important how much time I put into it. It's important what you get out of it, because this 30 to 45 minutes can change somebody's life and their perspective. So you got to put your all into what you do.
Amen.
Is that what's up?
All right.
Is that the truth?
Amen.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. That's why I do what I do, man. I don't do what I do to be the next big mega voice. I do what I do to serve. I do what I do to impact someone, because that's what's important to me, is whether or not you receive impact. A lot of the times, people fill places up, but they're not impacting anything.
Man.
They're not changing anything. I work with a lot of people who go to some of the biggest churches around this in the Metroplex area. And they still got 50 filthy mouths.
Man.
They make the members. Still clubbing, still doing a whole lot of other stuff. But they are part of that big thing, but there's no impact being made. My goal is to make impact.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
If I'm not making impact, then what am I doing? If I'm not impacting anybody, if I'm not transforming it, that's why I get sick. Mm-hmm. When I see people's lives stay the same, yet you go through week after week of teaching and preaching, but your life ain't changing. That bothers me.
Amen.
And it should bother anybody, but unless you just caught up in the wrong thing, it don't bother you. You just counting heads and collecting money and going about your business. I want to see people's lives change. Maybe I'm naive. Maybe that don't work anymore. But I believe in it.
Amen.
Wonder why I believe in it? Because my life changed. Oh, y'all not hearing what I'm saying. Anyway. Here's something I want to give you. Being able, I need y'all to write notes too. Being able to fight spiritual battles is extremely important in the life of God's people. Above all.